Hello. Today we're going to talk about how you can use CVAT and Datumaro to annotate data and prepare datasets for model training. Let's start. Our first tool is called Computer Vision Annotation Tool, or CVAT. It's used for annotating data, as you might suspect. CVAT development started at Intel in 2017 and was open sourced in 2018. It became a separate company, cvat.ai, in 2022. The code is open source, published on GitHub. It's an incredibly popular tool with more than 1 million Docker downloads, 8,100 stars, 2,200 forks, and 183 contributors. I'll show a video demonstration in a later slide, but in summary, it saves you time by automating a lot of the annotation process. It can label many types of data for different tasks, integrate with other tools, and scale for different team sizes. The second tool is called Dataset Management Framework, or Datumaro for short. Datumaro is also open source and developed by Intel and cvat.ai. In fact, it was originally a library inside the first tool, CVAT. Although Datumaro grew into its own separate tool, it is still used with and inside CVAT for data management. For example, importing, exporting, transforming, and versioning. It can be used as a Python library and as a command line tool. If you're interested in the company behind the development of these tools, cvat.ai, here are some links. You'll find the repositories for CVAT and Datumaro, cvat.ai's homepage, and an online version of CVAT. Here's a visual of the whole model training process. The box section is what parts CVAT and Datumaro help with. You start by acquiring data. This can mean downloading a public dataset, collecting data yourself, or a combination of both. Public datasets are particularly useful as benchmarks for researchers. Testing different models on the same data allows researchers to make apples-to-apples comparisons with respect to accuracy and other metrics. However, a common problem with public datasets is that they often require adjustments to be useful, especially for commercial purposes. For example, the data may not fit the use case accurately, it may be prohibited for commercial use, or maybe the image or annotation quality may not be good enough. For these reasons, people often decide to collect and annotate data manually. You might call this the dirty work, and it's where CVAT and Datumaro come in. Computer vision is a large space. You'll find an entire market of tools to solve these problems. Listed on this slide are some of the most well-known commercial and open source tools. We've discussed a lot of features and illustrated the big picture so far. Here's a suggested workflow to get started. First, collect the data. This can be a set of images, videos, or point clouds. Then, create a CVAT project using that data. Next, annotate the data with CVAT. This can be done manually or automatically, or both. Once it's annotated, export it into the proper format needed for training using Datumaro. Finally, use Datumaro to do the rest of the pre-processing. For example, splitting the dataset. And at this point, you're ready to train the model. We've recorded a video that walks through a demonstration of the entire workflow. If you're interested, it's on our YouTube channel. We highly recommend getting some hands-on experience with these tools. If you're interested in some homework, register at app.cvat.ai. Once it's set up, play around with annotating and exporting a dataset of your choice. You can visit our GitHub repository at github.com/opencv/cvat to learn more. Thanks for watching.